guys, it's Becky with Design Bundles, and today I am here to talk to you about faux rhinestone designs. Now, faux rhinestone designs are a really great way to get that rhinestone look without all the hard work that comes with rhinestones. So we're gonna go ahead and show you about picking out a design, bringing it into the software, and then of course we will cut and complete a project. So hopefully you're as excited as I am. So let's go ahead and jump on in and get started.
Alrighty, so I have already purchased this design. It is from designbundles.net. And I'm going to upload it directly into Cricut Design Space. Now I do want to say this designer was very thoughtful and uploaded these ones here, these SVG files that are intended for Cricut. Because sometimes when you have too many layers or too much going on or the file is too big, then it can give you some problems. But that was thought of, and we're going to insert this into Cricut Design Space, and it is manageable for us. So the first thing I'm going to do is ungroup. Now, let's pause. Let's put the pause button on real quick. If you were making this design with regular rhinestones, okay, then this is the size that you would want to keep it. See how it says that the square measures 9.08 by 9.08? Okay, so what you would do is you can tell, let's see, just the square. We're right at that 9.08 mark. Now, what that means is that those holes will be the right size to fit your rhinestones. Now, because we are working with faux rhinestones and I'm not going to use real rhinestones, that's not as important to me. So I'm just throwing that out there. You cannot resize this design without taking into consideration that this is sized for your rhinestones. All right, so I'm gonna get rid of that and I'll get rid of this. And I wanna grab this design and just make sure it's attached, which it already is. And normally a design like this, I would fill it with a circle monogram font, but that's actually not, it's not what I'm going to do today, because number one, we're going to think outside the box, but number two, I'm not a fan of monograms myself, and I'm going to make this shirt for my daughter. So I'm going to use just a fun font that I really like the letter M for. So once it updates, I can just simply take that font and enlarge it to fit into the circle. Now I don't want to go too big with it because I don't want to mess up the rhinestone design. So let's zoom in. Yep, it was just a little big. That's okay. We can make it a little bit smaller and fit it right in there. And there we go. So that's what I'm going to use. You can also use clip art or anything like that. So don't feel like you're restricted. But because I'm doing this, again, as faux rhinestones and not real rhinestones, then I'm able to put whatever I want in the middle of that. Now I am going to attach these together because I'm going to cut this all out of the same color. And I want to size it. I'm just going to do 8 inches to fit the size of her shirt. I will go to make it. And I do want to make sure that I mirror this design because I'm cutting it out of holographic heat transfer vinyl. I'll hit continue. Now holographic heat transfer vinyl has specific cut settings. So make sure that you do some research with wherever you've purchased your vinyl from. And the one I'm using in particular tells me to use the light cardstock setting. So that's what I'm gonna use. So let me jump over to my machine and cut this design, and I'll show you how it weeds, some tips and tricks, and what it looks like once we're done.
Okay, so I have removed this from the mat. This is the gorgeous holographic vinyl that we're using. And I just want to trim around the edge. With that out of the way, what I want to show you is that this is a tough type of vinyl. What I mean by that is that it's not as easy to weed. So what I like to do is just pierce underneath. Can you see how I did that? From the corner. And just start rolling it back. Now the awesome thing about these faux rhinestone designs is they are really, really easy to weed, especially with the holographic. Now, can you see here how this tore? That's not a big deal. I just wanted to show you that sometimes when you're working with the holographic, it is prone to tear. And And you do want to make sure that you're not pulling up any of your circles. Okay, so not that you have to be careful with it, but just try to be observant. There we go. So that is our weeded design. It's really easy, like I said, really simple and easy. And that is how it turns out. So let's grab our shirt in the heat press. Now this is just a simple black shirt. It's a little wrinkled, but that's not a problem because we're gonna do our pre-press. So I'm gonna set this down, folded it in half. We're gonna smooth it all out and grab the easy press. And we're just gonna, you can apply a little bit of pressure, but we're gonna let it set here and give us that good pressing line while also removing the moisture from the shirt. With that taken care of, smooth it back out, but lay it flat. And then you can apply your rhinestone design and use your pressed line here to center it. There we go. Grab your Teflon sheet. And we'll be able to do this one in just one press. We're doing 320 for 15 seconds. Now, holographic is usually a cold peel. It can vary by manufacturer, so just check the manufacturer settings to see what they recommend. So remove the Teflon. We're going to allow it to cool. Now what I'll do, I just try to get some airflow. Okay, pull it up off because your heat press will heat up the backing of whatever you're pressing it on. Now one way to know whether it's a cold peel or not is that if you were to attempt to remove this, then it would not adhere to the shirt. So if you ever have that problem, if you are pressing something and you try to take this off and it doesn't adhere to the shirt, that's okay. Bring your Teflon sheet back over and press it again, but then you're gonna wait for it to completely cool before you take off your carrier sheet. So let's give this just a minute and we will see what happens. All right, let's take a look. Like I said, just want to make sure that everything adheres to the shirt. And there we go. That is what we have, and that is what we wanted. So holographic is very smooth. You can hardly feel it on the shirt. And it, like I said, just looks really great for these faux rhinestone designs. So, how do you feel? I really, really love the faux rhinestones. And of course, part of it's because I absolutely love this holographic HTV. So there's just so much that you can do with it. And, you know, again, I'm all about that wow factor. And you really get that using this type of technique. And it's really super easy. I mean, you saw the weeding on this. It was just absolutely a piece cake. So, all right, guys, well, if you have any questions and comments, you know, please make sure you leave them below because we do always come back and check with you guys. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel because we always, always have a lot of great tutorials just around the corner. Hopefully, we'll be able to help you guys along your crafting journey. So, thanks for watching today, and we will catch you next time.